السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. We can be through the Ibrahim together inshallah. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما repeated me. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت
على إبراهيم
وعلى آل إبراهيم
وعلى آل إبراهيم
إنك حميد مجيد
إنك حميد مجيد.
اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد
وعلى آل محمد
كما باركت على إبراهيم
على إبراهيم
وعلى آل إبراهيم
وعلى آل إبراهيم
إنك حميد مجيد
إنك حميد مجيد.
Alhamdulillah, today we have our guest speaker, our Sheikh Hafiz Sheikh Anis al-Haq, Sayyid Anis al-Haq, Imam and Khatib of East London Masjid. And before him, I will talk about regarding some virtues of Quran, fadail of Quran. We have countless hadiths, 1,000 hadiths regarding Quran and the fadail of Quran, but I only mention few hadiths and I'll finish inshallah by what is the main objective of coming to madrasa. I will highlight some important points that inshallah I will finish. And Abi Umamah radiallahu anhu qal, سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول يقرأ القرآن فإنه يأتي يوم القيامة شفيعا لأصحابه. أبو أمامة رضي الله تعالى عنه narrates that I heard the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, recite the Quran for it shall come on the day of resurrection as an intercessor for those who recited it. وعن عثمان بن عفان رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه. عثمان بن عفان رضي الله تعالى عنه narrates that the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the best of you is he who studied or who learns the Quran and teaches it. I repeat again, the best of you. Who said the hadith? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do you have any doubt about that?
No.
When our Prophet said, the best of you is he who learns the Quran and teaches it, we have to believe that. And question is why? I always say, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is number one. Or do you have any question regarding this? Allah is the best. And Allah is number one. His book also number one. And whoever studied his book, whoever learned Quran, they also become number one, inshallah. If today people not recognize your status, or people, or your relatives, or your family members, then we have the evidence from hadith Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In another hadith, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, our mother Aisha narrated, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَلَّذِي يَقْرَوُ الْقُرْآنِ وَهُوَ مَاهِرٌ بِهِ مَعَ السَّفَرَةِ الْكِرَامِ الْبَرَرَةِ وَالَّذِي يَقْرَوُ الْقُرْآنِ وَيَتَطَعْتَوُ فِيهِ وَهُوَ عَلَيْهِ شَاقٌ لَهُ أَجْرَانِ. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the one who is an expert of the Quran, like our Sheikh Sayyid Anisul Haq, mashallah. The one who is an expert of the Quran is with the noble, righteous angel, subhanallah. If we become right, perfect reciter of the Quran, then our status will be like Jibreel alayhi salam, say subhanallah. Like Jibreel alayhi salam, noble and righteous angels. And he who recites the Quran while has difficulties, he also received double reward. Subhanallah. Another hadith from Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن الله يرفع بهذا الكتاب أقواما ويدع به آخرين. Allah تبارك وتعالى elevates some people through this Quran, through this book, and debases others through it, subhanallah. If we have Quran and we have attachment with Quran, association with Quran, then we will have no chaos in our houses as well. Today we have problems because we have no Quran. If we have Quran and every single day we try to recite Quran, then Quran will make our house inshallah peaceful. And Quran will lead us Jannah, and we'll have goodness of this world and the hereafter. Next hadith, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من قرأ حرفا من كتاب الله فله حسنة والحسنة ألف حرف ولام حرف وميم حرف. No book in this world, or anyone can claim, if you read my book, then you will get 10 reward. But this only book exists in this world. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the person who recites one letter of the book of Allah shall receive one reward, and a reward is multiplied 10 times. And then Prophet said, I do not say that alif lam mim is one letter. Rather, alif is one letter, lam is one letter, and mim is one letter. Imagine by reciting one page, you can receive 1,000 rewards. And if you recite Quran 1 hour, then you will get million rewards. One of our sheikh is to say, Sheikh al-Hadith, Allama Aziz al-Habb, rahmatullahi alayhi, he used to say, if we have intention to memorize one surah, he gave one example like Surah Takasur, we need to read 1,000 times, or minimum 100 times. And Quran is lifetime project. If we memorize Surah Yasin, we cannot say this is finished. We have to revise, we have to repeat every single day or every other day. Therefore, Quran is lifetime project. When we memorize, inshallah, this Quran is lifetime project, we will recite, we will repeat every single day or every other day. Then inshallah, by Quran, we'll get 1,000,000,000,000,000,000 reward. And by having reward, inshallah, we can achieve Jannah. Because Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, in the hadith, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Quran will intercede on behalf of us. Quran will say on the day of judgment, wa Allah, grant him Jannah. Because he used to recite Quran, he memorized Quran, and Allah will not reject the intercession of Quran. By this, inshallah, we can achieve Jannah. The last hadith, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, يقال لصاحب القرآن اقرأ وارتقي ورتل كما كنت ترتل في الدنيا فإن منزلتك عند آخر آية تقرأها. On the day of judgment, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the person who was attached to the Quran, who memorized Quran, will be ordered thus, continue reading and continue climbing now. Then our mother Aisha said, Allah designed heaven like Quran. Like Quran has 6,666 verses. We'll have inshallah rank of Jannah also like that. Then whoever recites, memorize Quran, he will get definitely inshallah rank higher than others. Therefore, if we cannot memorize whole Quran, if we memorize 1,000 verses, Juz Amma, Surah Yasin, Surah Rahman, inshallah we'll get also high reward than others, high rank than others. Therefore, don't ever think, my son cannot finish Quran memorization, he memorized only 5 Juz, or 10 Juz, or Surah Yasin, Surah Rahman, he still is, subhanallah, This is, I will believe that memorizing Surah Yasin is not a small achievement. We have to understand that Yasin is the heart of the Quran. And when you memorize Yasin, and I said earlier, we have to repeat every day or every other day. Because of Yasin, inshallah, we'll get Jannah, inshallah. Highest Jannah, Jannatul Firdaus, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to understand. I will say only few objective of why should we come to madrasa. And our parents, they, mashallah, they come in 4 days a week, Monday to Thursday. After work, coming to madrasa with children, this is also one of the hard job. But when we understand we are spending time for our children, and this is my main job, this is the best job, then we will not take this is like difficult. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to understand. I asked one of my class, what is the main objective of coming to madrasa? One said learning Quran, others said learning du'as, others said learn about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and others said learn hadith, and some said become better Muslim, become best of the best. Sometime when we ask our students, they said only one thing, to learn Quran. Our shuyukh, our scholars used to say, when we come to madrasa, we can make intention as much as possible. Then we will get, inshallah, more reward if we come to madrasa to become better Muslim. Learn about Allah, learn about hadith. And also, subhanallah, I will say one thing, learn about Allah. It is one of the obligations for Muslims. When we learn about Allah and we understand the power of Allah and punishment of Allah, then we cannot miss Salah. We cannot miss Salah, we cannot disobey Allah. When we understand the power of Allah, Allah can take me now, then we cannot disobey Allah. Therefore, one sheikh, he explained about taqwa. He said, Muslim, or if this is our all human, this is our nature, always we try or we want to do something. He said, before starting or before doing the action, pause a moment and think it is beneficial for this world or the hereafter. If it is beneficial, then do it. If not beneficial, then don't do it. Then you can have life of taqwa. Today, we waste our time. We don't understand the time from Allah. One dua, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us, in the morning we should make, Alhamdulillah, alladhi ahyana, بَعْدَمَا أَمَاتَنَا وَإِلَيْهِ النُّشُورِ. What is the meaning of this dua? We saying, Alhamdulillah, all praise due to Allah. أَحْيَانَا بَعْدَمَا أَمَاتَنَا. Oh Allah, you gave me life after death. When we believe that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave me life. And this is gift from Allah, time from Allah. Then when we come to madrasa, when you give time for Allah, then we'll feel, this is my best time. This is my golden time, because giver of time is Allah, and I'm giving time for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today we have time for everything. We time for everyone. We time for everything, but we have no time for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we understand this point, and we spend time for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah will grant us goodness of this world and the hereafter, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us peaceful life, inshallah. I will finish by this. All of our parents, those attend today, please make dua. Dua is the key of success. And parents' dua for children, Allah will not reject. Therefore, morning and evening, after salah, whenever you have time, please make dua. And you must include in your duas, oh Allah, make me my son or daughter, Hafiz of the Quran. Oh Allah, grant me, you make them pious. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of your dua, make them hafiz of the Quran and grant them pious, and they have love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they have love for Islam and religion, then your life and your children's life, your generation will be saved from Jahannam. And when we have no time and we don't care about this, and we leave our children without religion, without Islam, without love of Allah in Quran and Sunnah, then we don't know what happened. And I will ask my students, please also, this is our duty also make dua for our parents. We should make dua this day. Our parents is the best gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we lose them, when we lost them, we lost forever. Therefore, we should make dua for our parents as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them pure life and healthy life. May Allah accept our madrasa, madrasatul nur, wa akhir.